ャムの豚さん。
Hi everybody, this is Adriel from Profit From Property. Today I'm back again to touch on a very popular topic, which is freehold versus leasehold property. There are two schools of thought that is a common topic of discussion amongst buyers. It's a freehold or a 99 years leasehold condo better. There are both pros and cons for both leasehold and freehold tenure properties. The key is to understand the performance of each respectively and how it affects you as a property investor or a homeowner.To note, usually there's a premium for freehold tenure properties and it will be priced slightly higher due to the tenure of the land. Here's the first example of a 99 years leasehold development, Soleil at Sinaran and Park Infinia, a freehold development which are both located in the Prime District 11 Novena. Let us now identify the key trends for each. In the early stages of year 2009, Soleil, the 99 years leasehold condo,per square foot pricing was consistently lower than Park Infinia, the freehold condo. However, if you can see in the first 5 to 6 years, Soleil's overall price appreciated faster in comparison to the freehold condo Park Infinia. The PSF even went on to surpass Park Infinia as well at a peak of year 2013. As for Soleil subsequently, you can see the price started to experience a slight dip and remains fairly stable, whereas for Park Infinia, the freehold condo also appreciated during the same timing but didn't go as high as Soleil. When Soleil started to stabilize in price, the interesting thing here is that Park Infinia prices trended upward again at the later stages from year 2018 and its PSF went on to become higher than Soleil's. Now, we have to look at the rental performance for the two properties. Comparing the two-bedroom rental for Soleil and Park Infinia, both unit size range between 1,000 to 1,100 square feet. We can see the current rental price for Soleil 2-bedroom is at an average of $6,000, whereas Park Infinia's 2-bed rental is at an average of $4,500. Even from the beginning, Soleil at Sinaran has consistently commanded a higher rental than Park Infinia due to its location. Soleil is closer to the MRT and amenities as compared to typical 999 or freehold properties that may be slightly less accessible and not as convenient. The second example we will look at is Signature Park, a freehold development, and South Haven 1, a 99 years leasehold development, both located again in the same vicinity, District 21. Both condos are launched at almost the same price, with South Haven 1's PSF being slightly lower than Signature Park. The two projects experienced the same price trends and appreciation within time. The similar thing happened where the price for the 99 year leasehold project South Haven 1 started to stabilize again and the freehold project Signature Park continued to experience price increase. What can we learn from all these examples above? In summary, if we are looking at a shorter investment horizon, the 99 year leasehold development will be more ideal. Its entry price is normally lower and in the shorter term, it appreciates faster due to its location and its rental yield. However, the duration of when a 99 year old condo prices reaches a maximum peak is time sensitive. For longer horizon, we can look at freehold condo as we do not have to worry about the years of lease left on the property remaining. It has a longer runway for the price to move up. Most of the times, we see people buying freehold as a form of legacy holding. The freehold tenure property also has lesser transactions as most owners are more inclined to hold on to their properties. The lower transaction volume can result in rarer supply in the future, and this is also one underlying fundamentals on why the prices can experience a surge in the later stages. Ultimately, it depends on your investment or ownership horizon. If you are looking to maximize your returns in the shortest possible time, then 99 years leasehold is ideally more suited for you. For the intention of a longer ownership period, go for freehold. This will be good for home buyers who are looking for own-stay property and intending to hold it for more than 10 years or looking to pass it down to their children. Of course, with all that has been discussed, there are still other factors to consider too when choosing between a freehold or a 99-year leasehold property, such as the maintenance fee and upkeep of the development. Most importantly, this is also very much depending on the individual development itself, and it does not necessarily mean it is a one-size-fits-all trend that applies to all freehold and 99-year lease properties in the same location. I hope you guys have found this content very useful for y'all. Do subscribe to follow us for more video. I'm Adriel, Profit From Property.